Welcome, class. Today we are going on a trip. So a trip involves traveling from one location to another, moving locations, such as walking. I am walking to the other side of the board. That would be the present tense, walking. Now our trip is going to take place in Tiful City, very creatively named, I know. So some characteristics about cities, we'll call this the city right here. It's got big buildings. Big buildings right here, and this is typically where you might find work. A lot of people work in these city districts in an office building. Right there. Okay, in cities you would also find apartment complexes, which is a housing complex. It's where you live, where you stay. Or you will also find residential houses. Now throughout cities there's lots of different transportation. There's lots of public and private transportation. So let's take a look at some of your public transportation options. So depending on where you are, you might have boats or ferries. It's typically what they're called. So that would be in a city like over here. This is Seattle. This is Space Needle. But there's lots of water near Seattle. And so to get across the water, you need a boat or a ferry. And you ride the ferry from here's your house, down the ferry, and you ride the ferry across the water to get to the city. If you're at work, you rode the ferry to work. Or if you are on the ferry, you are currently riding the ferry to get to your house or to get to work. Another form of public transportation might be a form of car, like a taxi cab, also known as a taxi, or just a cab. Those are the more abbreviated versions. More common today, you will find lots of Ubers. How many of you have ordered an Uber? Yeah. There you go. You guys are already familiar with this vocabulary. Very nice. So, another form might also be a bus. Lots of bus stations. So if we look here in our Tiful City and our make-believe Seattle, these blue bees are the bus stations. So you can ride the bus all around town. To the park, we're going to use green to symbolize park because they usually have lots of grass. Let's go park there too. Here's a park here in Tiful City. So you can ride the bus, or you're riding the bus, or you rode the bus. From your house, to the city, to work, you rode the bus to the park. Lots of different options there. Another system might be a train system. Yeah, you guys, we've gone over these really basic forms of transportation before. We're just building your vocabulary. It's nothing extremely new. You're familiar with these concepts. It's just new words. So in these cities, you will usually find a subway system, which would be underground. Down below. Under the ground would be a subway system. Sub means under. And that's a type of train, a train system. These might also be called metros, depending where you are. Another form of train or rail car would be your trolley system. Those are these little red boxes with wheels. So a trolley car. Trolley cars will be around some cities, much like San Francisco. But just like a bus, you can take these to different areas. It just might be more limited. then say you want to go a long distance. So when you go on a long distance trip, you can drive on a road, like a highway or a freeway, to get from one city to another, to one town to another, and you usually will drive on this in a car or a bus or an Uber, depending on the difference of how far you're going. Sometimes they even have trains that will travel from a place like Idaho to Oregon. That was a really bad Idaho, forgive me. so you can take the road. Say you were going from New York to Seattle, it would take a couple of days. So you don't want to take a couple of days, you want to take a couple of hours for your travel time. Well, you have the option to ride in an airplane. An airplane flies in the air, so you would fly in the plane to get from one city to another city. Now, that's some public transportation. Some more private transportation would be like your car or your bike or walking and running and jogging, all of those different forms. Now, we're going to do a little practice. We've worked on past and present and future tense before, but we want to apply that specifically to traveling. So I have a couple of sentences. I'm going to divide you into groups, number off 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Perfect, you guys are in groups, you're in teams now. And I have a couple of sentences for us to work with. Now these sentences, I want you guys to fill in the blanks of how to get from one part of the city to another part of the city. And there's more than one correct answer, which is great. So long as you're using the right verb tense and it's possible on the map, you've got it. If it's logical as well, not everything is on this map because it's imperfect. It's not an actual city map. I didn't look up all the bus stations in Tiefel City. Okay. So, first example, I'll do this one to show you guys before we start. And we'll have a little competition and you guys will race to see who can fill out these blanks the fastest. Well, let's do this first one. Let's see, have you blank a blank before? Well, I like boats. So, have you ridden or rode a ferry? Because we want to use our new vocabulary. Not just a boat, it's a ferry. Have you ridden a ferry before? Yes. Yes, I have. They're very fun, very nice. Someone help me with the second one. So take the blank from your apartment to the park. Take the blank. What can we take? What can we ride? A better word here would be ride. So what can we ride from the apartment? Say this is our apartment building to the park. Well, there's a trolley system right here, a train system. So let's say take or ride the trolley to the park. Yes, that was a great idea. That is very logical. So we will ride the trolley from your apartment the park. Brilliant. So I have another set of questions and divide into the teams and we're going to race. Brilliant. So here are the questions and you will come up. Yeah, I will start you and you will come up by I'll read the first question. So I will blank from my house to work.